This series is composed of samples measured by Agilent's microarrays. If you open one of the sample records, you'll find that the registered data are normalized and pre-processed values. The raw data files of the experiment are also provided from the supplementary file section. For reanalysis, it is better to start over from the raw data if possible. You can also download the soft formatted family file. You can retrieve the platform information and sample attributes from the soft file. If your Subio platform doesn't have any organisms but for human data, create it for the mouse. Once you have a mouse organism, create a new platform in it from the soft file. It's a good idea to name the platform precisely for future use. Also, it would be helpful to include the GPL number to make the source of information visible. Make sure that the title line and ID column are selected correctly and complete the wizard. The newly created platform appears on the platform list. It is useful if you set up a column of gene symbols when you analyze the data. Once the platform is ready, import samples associating with this platform. Drag and drop the raw experimental data files you downloaded. Double-click on the title row, and then select the probe name column for the measurement ID. Select the G processed signal column for the 1 raw signal measured signals. Press the import button to finish the wizard. Check the number of data rows and the number of measurements in the platform. The imported samples appear in the samples list. Press the Edit Sample Information button. Extract GSM numbers in a column by separating file names at underscore. Use the lookup tool to integrate sample attributes described in the soft file. Select the column containing GSM numbers in both upper and lower tables, which are the key to merging the two tables. Select all columns to import. Delete the temporary column for editing, and save it. Now the table of samples becomes hard to see. So, hide unnecessary columns for a better view. It generally works if you set visible only the sample underscore title and sample underscore series underscore ID columns. Select all the imported samples and create a series to bundle and analyze them. For normalization, select a preset scenario, expression microarray. When the series gets ready, click the Edit Parameters button on the Setup Series tab. Import sample underscore title from sample information. Separate the information with an underscore. The original sample underscore title column is no longer needed. Use the Find, Replace tool to remove the string sample and retrieve the sample numbers. Move them to the ID column. Columns of information that are common to all samples are not for the parameter. The information control NGF is critical for analyzing this data set. Give the column title. For information such as 2H, if you erase the unit H, it becomes a number. Set the column as a numeric parameter. Restore H in the unit cell and give the column title. You now have the experimental parameters. Next, let's select the flag information for the analysis. Agilent's raw data files have a lot of flag columns. We recommend you use these four flags for quality control. Go to the Setup Dataset tab. The parameters you set appear in the Priority of Parameters section. Try setting it up as shown in this video. This setup is more straightforward if you do it as looking at the line graph view. You see samples divided into replicate groups. In the Priority of Parameters section, you can uncheck the IDs and save it as another dataset. We now have two dataset called All Samples to See Individual Samples, and Average to See Group Averages. Double-click on the axis of the chart, and set scale options like max, min, and ticks appropriately to make the graph easy to understand. Keep a description of the summary of the experiment and data sources in the Sample Info tab. In the Notes section, copy and paste the series information and organize it for easy viewing. Copy and paste the URL of this series as well, so that you can open it with a single click. From here on out, we're going to the preparation for the analysis based on the genomic location. If you don't need it, you can finish here. Edit the platform and fill the location-related columns. It's easy to work if you hide all columns but location-related ones. Divide the information in the chromosomal location column by the position of the delimiter character. Transfer the extracted chromosomes, start position, and end position information to the reserved column for them. Remove temporary columns for editing work. Copy and paste the location information into Excel. Use Excel functions to generate strand information from the start and end positions. Transfer the strand information created in Excel to the strand column of the platform's edit screen. Make sure the lines are correct and save your edits. Now you have the location information in the platform. Next, you create a genome. On the Table Browser tool in the UCSC Genome Browser, select the M9 version of the mouse genome. Select RefSeq genes at track. For output format, select all fields and specify the file name, then press the Get Output button to download. Change the output format to bed and rename the output file, then press the Get Output button. Press the Get Bed button to download. Let's import the bed file first to the genome panel. Finish creating the genome, then select it and press the Edit button. Use the lookup tool to get the information from the TXT file. Merge the two tables as matching the name columns to import the name to column. Rename the name to column to gene symbol. Drag and drop the gene symbol column to the top. It makes it easier to use the information during the data analysis. After saving the edit, load the genome data. Now genome view and other features are enabled. Open the chromosome tab at the bottom. Open the Select Chroms drawer tab from the right side, and organize the chromosomes to be displayed. You can now quickly see where the selected genes on the graph are locating on chromosomes.